Dear students, let us continue our study in this paper entitled Drugs of Abuse, and in this particular module we shall study about the psychoactive drugs. In the previous module, now you are already familiar with what are drugs and what is drug abuse, and you have also become familiar with the various terminology which are there in drug abuse. And if you look at the learning outcomes of this particular module, after studying this module, you shall be able to know what does the term psychoactive drugs actually mean. And you shall be able to be familiar about the historical perspective linked with these drugs. You shall be able to classify the different psychoactive drugs into the various categories, and you shall be able to comprehend or understand the mode of action of such drugs. So let us begin with knowing about psychoactive drugs. A psychoactive drug, which is also called as psychopharmaceutical or psychotropic drug, is actually a chemical substance that works initially on the central nervous system, where it affects the brain function, causing in the changes in perception, mood, consciousness, cognition and behavior. And all this you can relate with the term psycho. These materials can be used recreationally to intentionally change one's consciousness, or sometimes for ritual, spiritual or shamanic purposes. Several brain regulating drugs, they have medicinal use also, like they are used as anesthetics, analgesics and for the treatment of psychiatric disorders. But then these substances are being used as the drugs of abuse, and that's where you have to be knowledgeable about what are psychoactive drugs, how they function, what are the different categories, so that when you deal with the cases where the criminals have consumed this or you find these drugs at the scene of crime, you will be able to do a scientific investigation around it. Continuing further, psychoactive substances, they often cause independent alterations in perceptions and tempo that the consumer may feel pleasing, for example euphoria, or advantageous, like for example increased attentiveness may be felt, and are therefore supporting. Thus several psychoactive constituents are abused, that is used extremely, in spite of fitness risks or negative consequences. With the constant use of certain elements, psychological and physical dependence or addiction may progress. As it is potential for misuse and addiction, many administrations worldwide have posed limitations on drug manufacturing and trades in an effort to decrease drug abuse. So with this background, let us try to know about the history of these psychoactive drugs. The usage of psychoactive drugs can be found in primitive times. There is a historical evidence of the usage of psychoactive constituents, predominantly plants, dating back almost around 10,000 years, an ancient sign of traditional use over the past 5,000 years. The mastication of coca leaves, for instance, dates back over 8,000 years ago in Peruvian society. Therapeutic use is a significant aspect of psychoactive drug use. And in contrary to this, a number of suggestions which deserve to modify one's perception is as important as the determination to the satisfactory thirst and hunger. One of the first people to articulate this point of view, set aside from a medicinal context, was American author Fitzhugh Ludlow, and in his book, The Hashish Eater, he described the drugs and post-drug use experience as follows. He said, drugs are able to bring humans into the neighborhood of divine experience and can thus carry us upon from our personal fate and the everyday circumstances of our life into a higher form of reality. It is, however, necessary to understand precisely what is meant by the use of drugs. We do not mean the purely physical craving, that of what we say is somewhat greatly advanced. Specifically, the knowledge of the probability of the soul to go into a higher, to go into a lighter being, and a foretaste of deeper visions and more wonderful hallucination of the attractiveness, truth and the heavenly than we are usually capable to scout by the crashes in our prison cell. But there are not much drugs which have the influence of calming such desire. The whole set, at least to the degree that investigations have therefore far printed it, may comprise only the opium, hashish, and in rare circumstances, alcohol, which has illuminating effects only on a very specific characters. So all this I have told you is what Ludlow has written in his book, The Hashish Eater. Now, this association is not restricted to humans. Numerous animals eat diverse psychoactive plants like berries and even agitated fruits. Throughout the 20th century, several governments crossways the world primarily replied to the use of recreational drug by prohibiting them and creating their usage and trade a criminal offense. A remarkable instance of this is the prohibition period in the United States, in which alcohol was considered unlawful for around 13 years. However, several governments, government officers, and people in law enforcement have decided that illegal drug usage cannot be adequately halted by criminalization. Administrations such as Law Enforcement Against Prohibition, that is LEAP, has come to such an end trusting the current drug policies have unsuccessful in their intended goals of addressing the problems of crime, drug exploitation, dependence, juvenile drug use, ending the current of illegal drugs and the interior sale and use of unlawful drugs. So, with this historical perspective, let us move further and try to know how these psychoactive drugs, which are used in medicinal use, that's why actually the various pharmaceutical companies, they are preparing these drugs, but they are also being used as the drugs of abuse. So that is something which is, from forensic science point of view, is of interest to you, and you should be able to know and have a better understanding around it. And as I told you, it is habit forming, and in the previous modules also we have seen it is really very, very dangerous, and you should always try to avoid these drugs. They are very dangerous to take, as they will form habit and will have serious repercussion on your body. So let us try to now understand the classification of psychoactive drugs. Psychoactive substances are taken by individuals for various reasons to attain a precise end. Several substances may have regulated or unlawful uses, while others may have shamanic reasons and still others are used therapeutically. Other instances can be social consumption or sleep assistances. Like if we talk about caffeine, caffeine is the world's greatest consumed psychoactive substance, but not like numerous other, it is legal and uncontrolled in approximately all jurisdictions. The psychoactive drugs are distributed into groups according to their pharmacological effects. And generally, the used psychoactive drugs and their groups are, we have narcotics, then we have the stimulants, we have depressants, we have hallucinogens. So these are the four broad categories. And now going into details of these one by one, first let us begin with narcotics. The term narcotics is taken from the Greek word narcotikos, which means a state of lethargy. This category comprises of substances that act on the central nervous system and they bring relief from pain and produce sleep. The source of most analgesic narcotics is opium, which is a sticky milky juice obtained from the unripe pod of poppy, and its scientific name is Papaver somniferum. Other examples include morphine, heroin, codeine, synthetic opiates, etc. Talking about morphine, morphine is obtained from raw opium and it is usually administered by injection by hypodermic needle, and this results in a euphoric state with sleepy and relaxed appearance of the user. It is usually 3 to 5 times stronger than opium. Talking about heroin, heroin is actually a morphine derivative. It is a diacetyl derivative of morphine. So it is also called as the diacetyl morphine. And heroin is a white crystalline powder which is obtained by adding two acetyl groups to morphine, and this is done by the acetylation reaction. Heroin in impure form is also known as brown sugar. It is almost 10 to 15 times stronger than morphine, and it may be either injected, or many of these users, they sniff it to cause similar effects as that of opium and heroin, but with a much higher magnitude. So all, even the ways of administration you should be aware about. Codeine. Codeine is also derived from morphine, but it is less effective as analgesic, and it acts as a base in many pain relievers, and in very minute quantity it is also used in some cough remedies. Now coming to the next category, which is stimulants. The drugs of this category are generally called as uppers, and they comprise the substances that wake one up, stimulate the mind, and may even cause euphoria but do not affect the perception. And these are also referred in the terminology of speed. And the examples include amphetamines, methamphetamines, caffeine, nicotine, and cocaine, etc. If we talk about amphetamines or its derivative, which is methamphetamine, they may be injected directly inside the blood current through intravenous injection. The desire for a more strong experience is the chief motive behind this route of administration. The preliminary feeling of a flash or rush is followed by intense feeling of pleasure, euphoria that produces hyperactivity, with a feeling of clarity of vision as well as hallucinations. And after the effect wears off, the individual passes through duration of exhaustion and may sleep continuously for 1 or 2 days. Talking about methamphetamine, it is a derivative of amphetamine, and you can say it is another form of amphetamine, and this is also called as speed because of its rapid stimulation of the central nervous system. Cocaine is also a powerful stimulant that produces similar effects as that of amphetamines, namely increased alertness accompanied by suppression of hunger and fatigue. It is generally sniffed and is absorbed into the body by the mucous tissue of the nose. Another form of cocaine which is quite popular is called as crack, and this is manufactured by heating the mixture of cocaine, baking powder or baking soda and water. It is also snorted and produces similar effects like cocaine. But as I told you earlier, these are very dangerous and habit forming. Initially they are giving you these feelings, but then slowly they will be habit forming, they will bring fatigue, and in long doses they can lead to death. So never ever think of consuming them. But yes, you are studying them as forensic scientists so that you can do proper investigation when you come across these substances in the cases you are handling. Now moving to the next category, we are having depressants. The drugs of this category are called as downers, and they include sedatives, hypnotics and narcotics. This group comprises all the tranquilizing, sleep inducing, stress reducing, sedating substances which occasionally bring perceptual alterations like dream pictures, and also frequently induce sensation of euphoria. If we talk about examples here, they comprise the alcoholic beverages, mainly the ethanol, barbiturates, benzodiazepines, etc. Like alcohol, barbiturates also act on central nervous system to suppress its vital functions so as to relax and generate a sense of well-being and produces sleep. But that is only for some time, and after that it will be even a lower than what you have started with, and that's why your body will require even more and more, and that's why all these drugs are habit forming. Barbiturates are generally taken by mouth. The average sedative dose is about 10 to 70 milligrams, and there are about 25 barbiturate derivatives which are consumed in this manner. Some barbiturates are mixed more gently than others, and they are generally termed as long acting barbiturates, like phenobarbital. On the other side, certain barbiturates are absorbed rather quickly and are termed as short acting barbiturates, like pentobarbital, secobarbital, etc. And apparently abusers prefer the faster acting ones than the long acting or the slower acting ones. Coming to the fourth category, we have the hallucinogens. The drugs of this category include psychedelics, dissociatives, and deliriants. This group includes all those constituents that create dissimilar changes in normal thought processes, perceptions, and mood. There are various substances with varying chemical compositions that have hallucinogenic properties. And if we look at the examples here, we have LSD, which is lysergic acid diethyl amide, PCP, which is the phencyclidine, DMT, which is dimethyl tryptamine, mescaline, psilocybin, etc. Out of these, if we talk about LSD, which is very commonly used, LSD is manufactured from lysergic acid. And it is a substance which is derivative of ergot, which is the type of fungus that attacks certain type of grains. And this is a very potent drug. Only 25 micrograms is sufficient to start vivid hallucinations that may last for about 12 hours. This drug produces marked change in mood, leading to laughing and crying at the least aggravation. And feeling of anxiety and tension is always there to accompany the LSD use. On the other side, if we talk about PCP, that is the phencyclidine, PCP is synthesized by quite a simple chemical process and thus is much more readily available. It is frequently assorted with other drugs like LSD or amphetamine and is related as a powder, and also it is branded or labeled as the angel dust, available as capsules or tablets or even as liquid. And the drug is smoked, ingested, or even sniffed. Marijuana is an example of a psychoactive drug that combines the properties of each of these groups. So there are some substances like marijuana where all these properties are there in these of these categories of psychoactive drugs. And all these you should be familiar, and when you go to the crime scene, you should be vigilant enough so that you are able to take these evidences along with them, and in the subsequent modules we will see how their analysis can be done in lab using the various chemicals which are used as the spot test, the color test, reagents, and with TLC and other instrumentation techniques. We should also be knowing about the mode of action. So if we talk about the mode of action of these drugs, psychoactive drugs, they control by provisionally disturbing an individual's neurochemistry, resulting in alteration in the individual's mood, thought, insight, and behavior. There are several methods in which the psychoactive drugs can distress the brain. Each drug has a specific action on one or more neurotransmitter or the neuroreceptors in our brain. Agonists are the medications that upsurge the action in specific neurotransmitter systems, and they act by increasing the synthesis of one or more neurotransmitters by reducing its reuptake from the synapses, or by mimicking the action by binding directly to the postsynaptic receptor. So any of these can be the mode of action. On the other hand, antagonists are the drugs that reduce neurotransmitter activity and operate by interfering with synthesis or blocking the postsynaptic receptors so that the neurotransmitters cannot bind to them. So in this visual, you can clearly see that how the presynaptic neuron is there, the postsynaptic neuron, and how there is a dopamine release which is happening, or the dopamine uptake, and that's how the neural signal is getting transmitted. But when you have this cocaine in the lower, the cocaine will block the uptake, and that is how it will be affecting the neural signal. So these drugs, they actually attack on the neurotransmission functions of your brain, and that is why they are also very, very habit forming, because once these nerves are in the habit of this state, then they will be very depressed feeling, and you will feel like taking more and more and more, and that becomes a very worse situation and can lead to entirely affecting your central nervous system and even leading to fatal conditions. Exposure to psychoactive substance can cause changes in the structure and functioning of neurons. As the nervous system tries to re-establish the homeostasis disrupted by the presence of the drug, exposure to antagonists for a particular neurotransmitter increases the number of receptors for that neurotransmitter, and the receptor themselves, they become more sensitive, and this is called as sensitization. Conversely, overstimulation of receptors for a particular neurotransmitter causes a decrease in both the number as well as the sensitivity of these receptors, and this process is called as the desensitization or tolerance. Sensitization and desensitization are more likely to occur when there is a long-term exposure to these drugs, although they may occur even after a single exposure if the amount is very high. And it varies from person to person. And the more it is consumed, it will be more habit forming, and it will having more effect on the central nervous system and ultimately on the entire body functioning. These processes are thought to underlie the dependence and addiction. So, dear students, never ever try to even taste these drugs. They are really deadly. But as forensic scientist, you should be aware about them. That is why you are studying them, so that when you are dealing with criminals who are behaving in this way or otherwise at the scene of crime, you find that the person who is dead has consumed this, whether it is the case of murder, that is, whether it is a case of homicide or it is the case of suicide, and then taking out the samples which are there available on the crime scene, or from that dead body you can identify that which particular drug of abuse was given or he or she has taken, you can identify that particular drug, and that can give you sufficient clue about the solving of that particular case. So let us now summarize what we have learned in this module, which dealt with psychoactive drugs. We studied that a psychoactive drug, which is also called as psychopharmaceutical or also called as psychotropic drug, they are nothing but the chemical substances that act primarily upon the central nervous system, where it affects the brain function, resulting in alteration in perception, mood, consciousness, cognition, and behavior. We also talked about the historical aspect of these drugs, and we studied that these psychoactive drugs are classified into different groups according to their pharmacological effects, and they are namely narcotics, stimulants, depressants and hallucinogens. We also studied that psychoactive drugs operate by temporarily affecting a person's neurochemistry, resulting in changes in a person's mood, cognition, perception, and behavior. We also studied about two broad categories of the drug, which are agonist and antagonist. Agonists are the drugs that increase the activity in particular neurotransmitter systems. They act by increasing the synthesis of one or more neurotransmitters by reducing its reuptake from the synapses, or by mimicking the action by binding directly to the postsynaptic receptor. On the other hand, antagonists are the drug that will reduce the neurotransmitter activity and operate by interfering with the synthesis or blocking the postsynaptic receptors so that the neurotransmitters cannot bind to them. Thank you.